Medieval Europe was a place of violence, barbarism, and ignorance. Blind bigotry and barbarity ruled society. Measures such as forcible conversions, torture, and slaughter in the name of religion had spread all over Europe. Medieval Europe first made the acquaintance of Islam with the founding of the Andalusian Umayyad state. With the Ottomans regarded as one of the greatest empires in the history of the world, Islamic virtue and culture led to major advances on the continent. Many historians and sociologists today openly state that Islam played a major role in the development of the European culture. Islam, which first entered Europe through Andalusia, is having an even greater impact on the region today. There are now some 38 million Muslims living in Europe as of 2009. That number is growing day by day. But this is not the first time that Europe had become acquainted with Islam. On the contrary, Islamic culture has always been an inseparable part of Europe. The first incident demonstrating to the Europeans that Islam was to occupy a large place in their lives was the capture of Jerusalem by the Blessed Umar. With that, Europe for the first time realized that Islam was expanding and heading towards its own frontiers. Indeed, the idea of recapturing Jerusalem from the Muslims was one of the main pretexts for the Crusades. On the course of their travels, the Crusaders who set out with that aim in mind encountered a truth they had never expected, a dazzling Islamic civilization that bore no resemblance to Christian Europe. This was the first development that would lead to a new age in Europe. While the Crusades were still taking place, European societies entered into a closer relationship with Muslims in lands far closer than those in which the Crusades were being waged. For example, in the southern part of the continent, in the Iberian Peninsula, or Spain as it is known today. The state of Andalusia was founded in those lands in the wake of the Muslim conquest of the Iberian Peninsula. With the foundation of that state, the accumulated science and philosophy of Islamic culture would have a major impact on Europe until the end of the 15th century. Spain in the Middle Ages was ruled by a Visigoth monarchy, but that state was utterly weakened by struggles for the throne, internal dissension, and social and religious conflict. Ordinary people were crushed under religious discrimination, oppression, and intimidation. With the Muslim conquest of Andalusia in 711 AD, a new age dawned for Europe. Within a short space of time, Malaga, Elvira, and Cordoba were also captured with the help of societies unhappy with the Visigoth rule. Thus the region quickly fell under Umayyad rule. Andalusia would remain a Muslim nation for the next 8 centuries and would introduce Islam to Europe. The installation of Islam in the region would mean an end to religious discrimination. Jewish, Christian, and Muslim communities began living in a harmony the like of which was seldom seen before. This exemplary behavior on the part of the Muslims of Andalusia stemmed from their adopting the Quran as their guide. Thus, the justice and compassion required by the moral values of the Quran came to dominate society. Many historians who have studied the impact of Andalusia on Europe are agreed that the state was one of the most important factors in the development of European civilization. The famous historian Blasco Ibáñez describes the civilization built by Muslims in Spain in these words. Renewal in Spain came not from the north, but from the south as a result of Muslim conquests. This was a movement of civilization more than a conquest. Thanks to this, the wealthiest and brightest civilization in Europe flourished in Spain right through the Middle Ages, from the 8th century to the 15th. At this time, the people in the north were racked by wars of religion and bloodthirsty hordes, barbarians, acted en masse while the population of Andalusia exceeded 30 million. And all races and religious groupings acted in harmony within that population. A huge figure for the time, and the public displayed a most vibrant pulse. Andalusia quickly became one of the most respected works of art and ideas of Islamic civilization. Andalusia was the source of the light that broke through the darkness of the Middle Ages and the Inquisition. great scholars such as Ibn Majah, Muhyiddin Ibn Arabi, Al-Qurtubi, and Al-Shatibi flourished here. These Muslim scientists made huge advances in many fields, such as technology, medicine, astronomy, algebra, and chemistry, proved themselves in the eyes of the whole world in the field of civilization and culture. In later years, the works of these scholars were translated into foreign languages, particularly Latin. Many people at the time were contracting contagious diseases, but owing to medical works by these scholars, Europeans learned modern methods of treating them. The translation of works by Muslim geographers and travelers led to Europeans obtaining geographical knowledge of the Middle East and Far East. Works by these scholars were later used as textbooks in many universities. With its hospitals, libraries, and schools that attracted students from Central Europe, Cordoba was regarded as the most modern city in Europe. A center of learning and culture grew there. Some 600,000 books were held in the Cordoba Library alone. With its extraordinary architecture, well-maintained and bright streets, and magnificent palaces, the city dazzled visitors. European Christians coming to Cordoba were amazed by the great splendor, art, and culture they encountered in the city. Sheila Blair, a Boston University historian, describes the glory that was Cordoba as follows.
Cordoba in the 9th and 10th centuries was one of the biggest and most exciting in Europe. We have descriptions of it by people coming and saying, all these flowers everywhere, this open streets, this wonderful light coming down. Northern cities were dark. Cordoba had running water. People lived in big houses. In contrast, in Paris, people lived in shacks by the side of the river.
During their time in Spain, Muslims established a huge cultural treasury. Over the course of 800 years, 80,000 palaces and mansions, 600 mosques, 80 schools, and 600 commercial centers were built in Cordoba alone. Only a few of these have survived down to the present day. One of the few remains of the glory that was Cordoba is the Catholic Cathedral in the heart of the modern city, or the Mosque of Cordoba as it is also known. This cathedral was turned into a church, having first been a mosque, after the city fell into Christian hands. Various additions were made to the mosque, which had a surface area of 23,000 square meters. It had orange trees in its courtyard without altering its essential nature, and it later began being used as a cathedral. With a sublime artistic conception in its architecture, this structure still amazes visitors from all over the world and exhibits the splendor and beauty of Islamic art. the most impressive structures in Andalusia is the Alhambra Palace, one of the most amazing examples of Islamic art and aesthetics. The sensitivity that Islam bestows on the human soul can be seen in its every detail. With its gardens adorned by flowers brought from across the world, its pools and stonework is one of the most glorious works of Islamic art. Verses, the names of Allah and the words, "There is no other conqueror than Allah," can be seen in much of the stonework. It was the descriptions of paradise in the Quran that inspired the Muslims of the time to create such amazing works. The depictions of paradise in the Quran describe the highest possible quality, exquisite taste, and a dazzling splendor. Because many verses of the Quran describe high columned floors, lofty staircases, green fields stretching as far as the eye can see, mighty pillars, fields with rivers flowing through them, and gardens and orchards full of produce that bestow a feeling of great well-being and relaxation on the beholder. Verses state that the mansions in paradise are all of that kind. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. But those who fear their Lord will have high-ceilinged halls, and more such halls built one above the other, and rivers flowing under them. That is Allah's promise. Allah does not break His promise. Muslims with this conception from the Quran in their hearts created matchless works of art over the course of history, and the countries they ruled became the most select, magnificent, and modern in the whole world. Andalusia has gone down in history as just one of these. The state of Andalusia came to an end in 1492 with the loss of Granada, the last remaining territory in Muslim hands. But now Europe was to make the acquaintance of Muslims arriving from the Balkans. Empire began expanding through the Balkans with a string of conquests. The peoples of the Balkans were one by one converting to Islam. But this conversion was never the result of pressure or force. The Quranic virtues embraced by the Ottomans led those who witnessed it to convert to Islam of their own accord. The civilization the Ottomans constructed on justice, equality, and compassion, commanded by the Quran, survived in the Balkans for approximately 550 years. The policies in the lands the Muslim Turks captured were justice, affection, compassion, and a far cry from racial bigotry. Muslim Turkish rule was therefore regarded as a salvation for many countries. Many peoples, especially the Orthodox Balkan peoples, who had been subjected to fierce pressure from Catholic Europe, elected to live under Muslim Turkish rule. Towards the end of the 15th century, it was not only Christians but also Jews who sought shelter under Ottoman rule in large numbers. Because they had complete faith in Ottoman justice and the freedom of belief they would be able to enjoy. The main reason why the Ottoman Empire and other Muslim states established a rule based on compassion, justice, and civilizations was that this was a pattern commanded by the Quran. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. Allah commands you to return to their owners the things you hold in trust, and when you judge between people, to judge with justice. How excellent is what Allah exhorts you to do. Allah is all-hearing, all-seeing. Another verse reads, I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. Allah does not forbid you from being good to those who have not fought you in the religion, or driven you from your homes, or from being just towards them. Allah loves those who are just. The traces of the civilization the Ottomans built in the Balkans can still be seen today. This civilization the Ottomans constructed on the basis of compassion, reconciliation, and pluralism made Islam a major force in Europe. The Balkans is still today home to many of Europe's Muslims. Muslims embodying the moral virtues of the Quran brought justice, compassion, reason, science, arts, beauty, cleanliness, and well-being with them wherever they went. The virtues learned from the Islamic world plays a major role in European civilization. As these facts become better understood today, Europe is once again becoming an Islamic region, and Islam has rapidly grown in the continent. Islam is currently enjoying rapid progress in Europe as it is in the rest of the world, and that rise has become much more evident in recent years. There is a constant flow of articles in the press about the rise of Islam. In addition, scientists and researchers are investigating the reasons behind that rise. In terms of the rise of Islam in Europe, researchers are concentrating on the migration by Muslims from many other countries. Indeed, a mass Muslim migration towards the West began in the 1960s. This had a major impact on Muslim numbers, of course. But investigators are concentrating on another aspect of this rise. In addition to Muslims arriving from outside, many native Europeans are also feeling an interest in Islam. There has been a significant increase lately in the number of people in Europe converting to Islam. Some 52,000 people across Europe converted to Islam in the first 10 months of 1992. A study conducted under the auspices of the United Nations in 1999 showed a more than 100% rise in the Muslim population of Europe between 1989 and 1998. In addition, European states now hold regular meetings and discussions with Muslim representatives, who now enjoy an official identity and listen to their demands. The subject can be understood more clearly when we have a closer look at the approach European countries have recently adopted towards Muslims. France. Over 5 million people of the population of France are Muslims. French politicians have recently been taking a much closer interest in Islam, the country's second largest religion. French President Jacques Chirac was the first to receive Muslim representatives. The French foreign minister signed an agreement with the representatives of 13 Islamic countries regarding the protection of Muslim places of worship. Italy. Approximately 1,200,000 out of Italy's total population of 60 million are Muslims. Muslims compose 1.4% of the entire Italian population. Some 50,000 Italians, largely women, have converted to Islam in recent years. There are 158 mosques all over Italy, and 50,000 Muslims are currently receiving primary and middle school education. The conversion to Islam of Torquato Cardilli, Italian ambassador to Saudi Arabia, also made an enormous impact. Cardelli's conversion to Islam once again raised the subject of the rapid rise of Islam in Italy. Germany. There are many converts to Islam in Germany, a country with a large Muslim population. There are about 50,000 Muslims of German origin. The German government is also implementing policies aimed to ensure that Islam is properly understood and presented. One of these concerns lessons in Islam to be given in German schools. Great Britain. Britain has one of the largest Muslim populations in Europe. There are more than some 2 million Muslims living in Britain. Reports concerning Muslims and Islam frequently appear in the British press. One historic moment came when a Muslim from Prime Minister Tony Blair's Labour Party was elected to Parliament and took the oath of allegiance on the Quran. Denmark. Denmark is one of the countries in which Islam is rising the fastest. Islam comes second only to the Protestants, the Danish state religion. Even the Catholic population is less than the Muslim population. In addition, the Danish state is contributing to that rise with its moderate policies. One particularly striking example of that support is the live coverage by Danish state television of the Friday sermon preached in the Turkish Cultural Center Mosque. Sweden. Research shows that there are 300,000 Muslims in Sweden, which has a total population of 10 million. The Swedish administration and public all adopt an open-minded attitude towards Islam. Because of the numbers of Swedish citizens converting to Islam, the Swedish government recently decided that the Quran should be translated into Swedish. and it also set aside funds to permit a large mosque in which Muslims can comfortably worship. In addition to these projects, the Swedish state has set up a separate assistance fund for schools teaching Islam in Sweden. Another major development set in action in Sweden, as the number of Muslims grows, is official recognition of Islam. Belgium. There are around 400 mosques and similar places of worship in Belgium, and the rise of Islam there is proceeding at full speed. In the early 1990s, there were around 285,000 Muslims in Belgium. By 1998, the figure had grown to 350,000. Today, Islam has replaced Judaism and Protestants as the country's second largest faith after Catholicism. In 1974, a law was passed guaranteeing freedom of belief and worship for Muslims. Muslims were thus given the freedom to live by and preach their faith in Belgium, in exactly the same way as Catholics, Protestants, and Jews. Norway. The Norwegian government registered a first when it permitted the call to prayer to be read from the minarets of Oslo's 8 mosques, from which the call is now regularly broadcast. Spain. Positive developments in terms of the rise of Islam have also been seen in Spain, the heir to Andalusia. The number of Muslims in the city of Granada has risen to more than 25,000 in the last 30 years. After an intervening period of 500 years, Islam is again flourishing in Spain. And according to formal statistics, there are over 1 million Muslims living in the country, while this figure was 150,000 20 years ago. Researchers have also stated that Islam is also coming to occupy an important place in other European countries. One such scholar is the German author Murad Hoffman, himself a Muslim and a diplomat of 33 years standing. This is what Hoffman had to say regarding the rise of Islam at a conference in Germany in 2000 titled Islam in the New Millennium. Those who said that Islam could never again make its way into Europe now regard it as an alternative if Western society is to free itself from its social and cultural problems. There is now a major movement among young people and adults towards Islam at the end of the 20th century, because Islam has cures for children, the young and families, and for the major problems facing our society in this century, and for the approach to knowledge and scholars. In his his book, Islam in the Third Millennium, Murad Hoffman makes the following striking statements. The West needs Islam in the same way that the Muslim world needs Islam. Islam has begun to shine at a time when all faiths and ideologies in Europe are bankrupt. I believe that the time when Islam will come to these lands, the West, is close at hand. Islam is expanding while the others are all contracting. Objective portrayals of Islam in the Western press are particularly worthy of noting. There has been visible progress in this field, particularly after the September 11th attacks in the USA. Many television channels, particularly the BBC, broadcast documentaries about Islam, aired discussion panels to which special guests were invited, and screened whole series discussing Islam. One example of these is the Season of Islam project carried out in Britain by the BBC at a cost of £1 million. This documentary was intended to be an accurate depiction of Islam and was broadcast by BBC Two in two weekly episodes. A similar program was aired by the ARC channel, a Franco-German partnership. It took 3 years to film this documentary about the life of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, a detailed examination of the history of Islam. In addition, many articles about Islam are intended to answer many questions about the faith that people might have, also appear in newspapers and magazines. The famous German magazine, Der Spiegel, took the rapid global rise of Islam as its cover story in one edition. The magazine devoted 20 whole pages to the subject, which appeared under the banner headline, "Who is the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him?" The subject elicited enormous interest. Studies by a range of institutions and researchers reveal that in the future, Islam will reign supreme across the world, not just in Europe. All these developments show that the time revealed in the Quran is close at hand, and has actually already begun. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. When you have seen people entering Allah's religion in droves, then glorify your Lord's praise and ask His forgiveness. He is the ever-returning. Recent years have witnessed a steady rise in the number of Muslims, not just in Europe, but in the world as a whole. Statistics calculated in 1973 showed a global Muslim population of 500 million, a figure that has risen to 1.57 billion today. One in every four people is now a Muslim. For the first time in history, the Muslim population has outreached that of the Christians. It is estimated that the Muslim population will continue to grow in the future, and that Islam will become the world's largest faith. The extraordinary scale of what is happening can be seen when developments related to this rise, which one can sometimes come across in press or television reports, are set out in order. These developments, which are generally depicted as ordinary current affairs, are in fact significant indications that Islamic moral values have begun their rapid expansion across the globe. Leading world politicians quote from the Quran and praise Quranic moral values at every available opportunity. They have begun visiting mosques and requesting detailed briefings about Islam during these visits. For the first time in world history, the Pope called on Christians to fast alongside Muslims for a day. Christian clergy quote from the Quran in their sermons. For weeks on end, the Quran was the best-seller book in European countries. Documentaries, interviews, and chat shows about Islam were broadcast by international television channels. Leading world newspapers frequently carry reports concerning Muslims and Islam. Books about Islam and the history of Islam are the most frequently requested works in public libraries. There is no doubt that these are highly significant developments. The rise of Islam shows that the world is heading towards a brand new age, in which, by Allah's leave, Islam will become ever more important and Quranic moral values will continue to expand among communities. The spread and dominion of Islamic moral virtues is something promised by Allah, and of which He tells us in the Quran. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. Allah has promised those of you who believe and do right actions that He will make them successors in the land as He made those before them successors, and will firmly establish for them their religion with which He is pleased and give them, in place of their fear, security. They worship me, not associating anything with me. Any who don't believe after that, such people are deviators. In addition to the verses of the Quran, our Prophet, peace be upon him, has also told us in many of the hadith that the Quranic moral virtues will one day rule the world. According to these, in the run-up up to the period referred to as the end times, people will first suffer a time of injustice, falsehood, war, conflict, fighting, and moral degeneration. After that will come the Golden Age, when Quranic moral values inundate the world and eventually rule it entirely. The Golden Age will be a time of justice, plenty, security, peace, and brotherhood. In the Hadith, our Prophet, peace be upon him, says that this sacred age will come about by virtue of the Mahdi. Hazrat Mahdi alayhi salam will appear in the end times and free the world from the disorder and moral collapse afflicting it. The current rapid turning towards Islamic moral values and the political developments taking place in this new age are important signs that the time referred to in the Quran and the Hadith of our Prophet, peace be upon him, is fast approaching. One verse tells us that, I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. They desire to extinguish Allah's light with their mouths, but Allah refuses to do other than perfect His light, even though disbelievers detest it. It is He who sent His messenger with guidance and the religion of truth to exalt it over every other religion, even though the idolaters detest it.